Welcome to the Grand Court at Macy's. I'm Peter Richard Conte, the Wanamaker Grand Court organist, and thanks for joining us for these Wednesday afternoon recitals. That was Grayston Ives' Intrada, which was written for Queen Elizabeth's Silver Jubilee service in St. Paul's Cathedral, London, on June 7th, 1977. Ives is a British composer, singer, and choral director. Until 2009, he had a wonderful title. He was Informator Chorustarum at Magdalen College in Oxford. He's also a member of the King Singers for many years. I'm gonna follow this with a piece by Claude Debussy. Debussy was one of the most influential composers in his native France and elsewhere. He possessed a wonderfully delicate command of nuance, whether in piano writing or in handling of a relatively large orchestra. I'm going to play for you the second arabesque, originally a piano piece, here transcribed by Léon Rogue, and it'll showcase some of the more stunning flutes and strings on this incredible instrument. Debussy's second arabesque. Thank you. That was Claude Debussy's second arabesque, transcribed by Léon Rogue. Now for a bit of fun, this is a piece with some history. I'm part of a group called the Philadelphia Organ Quartet, which was a group of four organists. As you imagine, not much music was written for 8 hands and 8 feet. One of my dear friends and now late colleagues, Michael Stairs, arranged this work for us, for the quartet. That's a piece with a lot of fun. And then I rearranged it as a solo work, and I'll offer it for you here. Fritz Kreisler was an Austrian-born violin virtuoso, and Arcangelo Corelli remains one of the most important figures in Italian composers of all time. And this is a set of variations on a theme by Corelli, by Fritz Kreisler. Originally arranged by the late Michael Stairs and rearranged by yours truly.
Thank you.
That was Fritz Kreisler's Variations on a Theme by Corelli, transcribed by the late Michael Stairs, and then rearranged by myself. I'll continue now with a piece by a Philadelphia local composer. Robert Elmore was one of Philadelphia's greatest musicians. Aside from being the official organist of the Philadelphia Orchestra, he was a virtuoso solo performer, a devout church musician, a dedicated teacher of young organists, and an inspired composer. Night Song, which I'll offer next, is dedicated to Virgil Fox, the brilliant American organist of the 20th century. Thank you. That was Robert Elmore's charming Night Song, written for Virgil Fox, who of course loved this organ dearly. I'll continue now with a piece by Antonin Dvorak. This is one of his Humoresques. Dvorak was in the United States at the Conservatory in New York from 1892 to 1895, and he jotted down some interesting musical ideas during that stay, and they became the core of his opus 101, entitled Humoresques, a cycle of short piano pieces. And this one is perhaps the most popular of them all. I think, as a kid, I remember this. Perhaps you'll remember the television show Slappy Squirrel. Well, this tune was probably, with Dvorak's chagrin, used as the theme song for Slappy Squirrel during that television series. It's a charming piece, always makes me smile, hope it does you as well. Dvorak, Humoresque number 7. I'm going to conclude this afternoon's program with Arthur Sullivan's The Lost Chord, which he wrote in 1877. His brother Fred was dying of an illness, and Sullivan wrote this piece at Fred's bedside. Arthur was very proud of the song and later noted, "I have written and composed much music since then, but have never written a second Lost Chord." The Lost Chord was hugely successful when it was published, and it was actually the subject of one of the first ever phonograph recordings in 1888. Arthur Sullivan's beloved The Lost Chord. That was Sir Arthur Sullivan's The Lost Chord to conclude this broadcast from the Wanamaker Grand Court at Macy's. I'm Peter Richard Conte, Wanamaker Grand Court organist. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you at our next broadcast.